Saving coral from the Great Barrier Reef, one species at a time.
What we have here are the living fragments in the Living Coral Biobank project.
They could last thousands of years in these controlled conditions while out on the reef.
In the last 20 or so years, we've lost 50% of coral abundance on the Great Barrier Reef. That's half of all corals have already disappeared. We've just seen another bleaching event this year.
It's the fourth time in 6 years. The outlook, dire, according to the latest State of the Reef report.
Despite official data confirming, the reef has experienced for the first time a mass bleaching during a cooler La Niña weather cycle this year. There's been very little mention of this great World Heritage listed national asset and the impacts of climate change during this election campaign.
The coalition has promised $1 billion in reef funding over 9 years, matched by Labor, then topped with almost $200 million to maintain an asset valued at $56 billion. It's a numbers game. Their emission targets both below the scientific consensus of what's needed to limit warming to 1.5 degrees, both also allowing new coal and gas projects.
Look, it's all well and good to throw lots of money at reef research and restoration-style activities. They're not going to save the Great Barrier Reef at the end of the day. What we need to see is very strong climate action.
Well, hopefully this will be a good luck.
Senat Kes, the Torres Strait, was once a happy hunting ground.
A coral bleaching, it'll affect our way of living because we live off the... we're seafaring people and we live off the sea.
Islanders now hunt the Australian government in UN corridors with a human rights complaint for failing to act on climate change.
Well, we need action right now.
The reef is the lifeblood of tourism in Queensland, bringing in over $6 billion a year before COVID.
The reef's still beautiful. It's still very much worth visiting.
They want to hear about a change of heading on the reef.
A lot of the things that are happening are really great. It's the long-term plan and the leadership from the government of the really big picture strategy that seems to be missing.
The reef's UNESCO World Heritage listing is again in danger.
We need a government to actually really step up to the challenge and to stop making excuses, because we are very, very quickly running out of time.
The next government will have to convince UNESCO later this year that it's doing enough based not on politics, but the science. Stefan Armbruster, SBS World News.